marriage and the sanctity that once came with it. It is either on life support in the United States of America, or it has died, and we have just refused to give it a funeral.
One of the things that has been troubling in American culture and American society is the devaluation of the sanctity of marriage and the outright assault that has been on marriage, especially over the last few decades. But you have to understand something. Marriage is the initial institution that God created. God created marriage. It wasn't created by a man. This is God's institution. It says in Genesis chapter 2, verse 24. Now, this is Adam speaking after God had created Eve for him. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. Notice, Adam said that. Where did Adam get that from? He got that from God. You understand that? But because our society has abandoned our biblical foundation, our biblical roots, you have people like Stephen A. Smith who are saying that he's 55, unmarried, and happy about it.
5 years old. I've never been married. And I'm happy about it. Now, that ain't the most popular thing to say. Okay? It's not the most popular thing to say. And the reason why it's not the most popular thing to say is because we live in a country and we live in a nation where we talk about, you know, the Bible talks about how, you know, a man who finds a wife finds a very, very, very good thing. In legal documents, he claims their marriage is irretrievably broken. Now, Jeannie Mai challenges Jeezy's divorce. Former friends are saying she's after his money. Now, I ain't trying to get in people's business. All of this stuff is publicized, stuff like that. I don't get into people's private business. If it's public, it's public, but I don't expose their private business. Talk about you, what you do on the field, to play, court to play, stuff like that. But I don't get it. I don't go this route. I'm not bringing this up to get into their private business. I'm bringing it up to make a point. I want everybody to listen. I want my nephew sitting to my left. I want my sister sitting to my right. I want my staff sitting outside. I want everybody to stop talking. Stop talking. I want everybody to listen to me, just like I'm asking America to listen to me, just like I'm asking people worldwide to listen to me, from all over the world. It's YouTube we're talking about here now. I need everybody to listen to me right now. Everybody listen. It's got to stop. Okay?
Marriage and the sanctity that once came with it. It is either on life support in the United States of America, or it has died, and we have just refused to give it a funeral.
Now, the reason why it has died is because they no longer esteem marriage as being the basic building block of a successful society. Marriage, a biblical marriage, establishes a biblical worldview. So what do you do if you want to destroy a society and you want to unmoor people from biblical foundation, from biblical truth? You attack marriage. It's a classic tactic of Marxism. Because Marx, Karl Marx, for those of you who don't know, was a strong adversary to marriage, because he realized that marriage was the vehicle, the mechanism that continued to distill a biblical worldview in society. And so he attacked marriage as his first thing that he wanted to destroy. Just look at all the nice little Marxists that have come along after him. What are the thing they attack? Marriage. Why you want marriage equality? Because the enemy knows that when you destroy marriage, you separate children from their parents. You are able to get in and infiltrate and influence that family to turn away from God. And what happens? That opens the door for all kind of secular, all kind of humanistic, all kind of demonic activity to take place in that home. And we have multiple homes that act like that, that have that environment. You have the communities that we have. And the Bible talks about this. It says in 1 Timothy chapter 4. Now the Spirit expressly says that in the latter times, some will depart from the faith, giving heed to deceiving spirits and doctrines of demons, speaking lies and hypocrisy, having their own conscience seared with a hot iron. But this is the one I want to highlight. Verse 3, forbidding to marry. Forbidding to marry. Now I know some people are talking about this divorce between Jeezy and Jeannie Mai and Hugh Jackman, his wife. But listen to this, I guess, model talk about how it's chic to be divorced at 30.
So it seems that a lot of ladies are getting divorced before they turn 30. And as someone who got married at 26, has been separated for a little over a year, 32, I have to tell you, I don't think there's anything better. If being in your 20s is the trenches, there is nothing better than being in your 30s, still being hot, maybe having a little bit of your own money, figuring out what you want to do with your life, everything, and having tried that married fantasy and realizing that it's maybe not all it's cracked up to be, and then you've got your whole life still ahead of you. So for all of those people who are stressed or feeling stressed about that, about being divorced, like, it's good. Congratulations. Congratulations.
See, it's those kind of attitudes that has led to the erosion of marriage. And people don't understand, as a child that grew up in a home that was wrecked by divorce, as a child that grew up with a father who was out the house, I know firsthand how devastating that is to a child. But people are selfish. Parents are selfish. They don't care about their children being victimized when they make these selfish choices. They think it's all good that the children can go back and forth between the households. It doesn't work. It doesn't work. On the surface, it may seem like it's working. It does not work. When you don't have a biblical foundation, a biblical marriage, husband, wife, children, no other arrangement will work. It may work on the surface. You may think it works. Only the grace of God can make it work. Only the grace of God in my life allowed me to be successful and a praying mother. But the statistics bear otherwise. So why would people willingly get into marriage knowing that they have this out clause? See, marriage is supposed to be forever. Marriage is a covenant. When you make a covenant with somebody, it's forever. People don't have that mindset. They don't have that mindset. That's why marriage to them is just convenience. That's why they have this no-fault divorce, which is the worst thing that was ever done. This no-fault divorce really made marriage just a matter of convenience. And so that's what we are. It's sad. You have people like Stephen A. Smith saying that he's 55, unmarried, and happy. And then you have this model, I guess, saying it's chic to be divorced at 30. And you have all the implications of all these divorces going around. But I'm here to tell you, we have to pray for marriages. Pray for people, because if marriage is destroyed, America is gone. I know a lot of people like to talk about, we put this person in the office or that person in the office, things have changed. No, unless we change the spiritual foundation of this nation, and especially if we have to, if we don't change our attitude when it comes to marriage, when it comes to the sanctity of marriage and the importance of marriage, that's the first institution that God created, and that's the only way a society can succeed, then America's done. It really is. America is toast.